It's a battle of bodies and four minds on this basketball court just outside Washington.
Don't intimidate me. Put the spud web on him.
It's Tuesday night at the Adams Center, one of the largest mosques in the U.S. The young people here are hard at play, and the Muslim elders are hard at work, trying to keep them engaged in positive activities.
Today we're just gonna go over what to wear, the permission slips.
After basketball, the younger kids meet for Boy Scouts.
You need to do some physical requirement. Get him to do it now because he's giving me the no attitude.
Keep your behind up.
After Scouts, hundreds gather for evening prayers. It's a tense time for the Muslim leaders, following the arrests in Pakistan of five young Americans from a neighboring community. The young men are being held on suspicion of links to terrorist groups. Sajjad Ahmad is the sports league coordinator at the Adams Center. He describes his reaction to the arrests.
Happy because I think the parents and the community took the right actions. Sad that, you know, members of the Muslim community, you know, kids that might have grown up that I might have crossed paths with sometime, you know, kind of got into that false ideology.
Ahmad says one of the center's top missions is getting youth involved in mosque activities.
They need to invest in activities where the youth can come and relate in a non-religious manner, so that when, you know, something involves religion, they know where they need to come back to. Oh, you know what, when I was playing basketball with so-and-so, I can maybe go ask him or her, you know, and that resource kind of gets embedded in their head.
Start out at home doing push-ups from your knees.
Imam Johari Abdul Malik is a Muslim community leader in the Washington area. He says young Muslims are often confused by disturbing internet images of their brothers in faith being killed in conflicts, and that one of his community's greatest challenges is helping young people interpret current events.
And that is when the internet comes in and says, your imam, your community, your youth center, your family, none of them have an answer for this, but we have an answer and we feel your pain.
Abdul Malik says Muslims face a modern challenge beyond shielding their young from traditional dangers like drugs and crime.
We have safeguarded them from the terrestrial threat of all the bad influences in their environment. But we didn't protect them from something that's inside of them that was connected through the internet. That is the next level of our fight against what I would call an enemy.
Many of young people are vulnerable to being preyed on.
Nihad Awad of the Council on American Islamic Relations, or CARE, helped broker talks between the FBI and the families of the young men arrested in Pakistan. He says Muslim leaders had already started looking at the dangers on the internet before the men went missing.
On the internet, the other side is trying to exploit people's feelings, and they give them instructions on how to do wrong things. We have to give tools and manuals also on how to stay cool and stay level-headed, stay reasoned, and don't get yourself and others in trouble.
At the Adams Center, that discussion has started too.
And we're telling parents, hey, this is what's available on the internet. This is what your kids are able to do, and some basic tips on if you want to increase security levels, if you want to do certain things, if you want to restrict things, you know, this is how you can do it.
What's most important, says Ahmad, is keeping young people in the game of peaceful resolution, what he calls a true teaching of Islam. Laurel Bowman, VOA News, Washington.